new study here in the U.S. concludes shutdown orders prevented 60 million infections. Our chief national correspondent Matt Gutman is in Phoenix, Arizona, where cases are spiking. Good morning, Matt.
Hey, good morning, George. And the cases are spiking here because of a near complete reopening. The state's health system is now telling them to activate their emergency plans. And it's not just here. 14 states are now seeing a surge in COVID cases.
Morning, with hard-hit cities like New York finally starting to ease restrictions, 20 other states and Puerto Rico are now reporting increases of COVID cases.
Okay, they have to be trolling us at this point. I mean, do they really think that we're all watching this and nodding our heads that, yes, it must be the lockdown protesters that are to blame for this rise in COVID cases? I know I say this a lot, but wow! I think I may have just had a series of serious neuroembolisms. Now, I do apologize for this interruption. We'll get right back to the video. But I gotta take this quick capitalism break to thank this episode's sponsor, BioTrust Ageless Multicollagen. Let me show you all one of the things that's helping me to look better and feel great. In the year 2020, it's important to keep your body healthy all the time. Collagen may be the closest thing that we ever get to a real fountain of youth. And many health experts now agree consuming collagen is as crucial as it gets to renewing and revitalizing how you look and feel. After all, collagen is the most abundant protein in your body and is essentially the glue that holds you together. In fact, after age 20, people produce about 12% less collagen in their skin each decade. For some, the decline is even greater. In short, this year-by-year escalating loss of collagen is a key reason people look old and explains why skin sags and wrinkles, hair gets thinner, nails lose their strength, joints become stiff, and in general, our bodies just seem to turn on us over time. So visit my page at www.healthwithdronetek.com and secure your supply of the best collagen on the market. It's okay though, I'm all right. I just need to take some deep breaths and I just need to calm down and go over the timeline here to just make sure I didn't walk into the Twilight Zone. First, they said 100% peaceful anti-lockdown protests were a bunch of disease-carrying, grandma-killing, racist, white supremacist terrorists. They said these protests weren't homegrown. They were spitting in cops' faces, burning flags, carrying swastikas and Confederate flags, and all they wanted to do was get haircuts.
There are growing concerns this morning over who is turning out for demonstrations against public safety measures in the coronavirus crisis. Protesters swarmed Michigan State Capitol again yesterday over statewide stay-at-home orders. Some of them had guns, big guns. The state's governor says she's concerned about possible racist elements among the crowd.
These have been really political rallies where people come with Confederate flags and Nazi symbolism and calling for violence.
Army of immigrants and people of color and poor people who are keeping this city running. They are disinfecting offices, they are cleaning people, they are changing bedpans, and they are working. And those people are out there complaining because they don't have haircuts? Who the hell do you think you are?
Protesters, are they hindering the state's ability to contain the virus in any way?
I am going to stay tethered to the science, the epidemiology. I'm going to make decisions based on facts, not based on, you know, political rhetoric or tweets for that matter. The risk of perpetuating the spread of COVID-19 is real. We've seen it happen, and that's why, you know, while I respect people's right to dissent, they need to do it in a way that is responsible and does not put others at risk.
To summarize, we were told to hate and fear these protests by the media, the Democrat Party, and by Hollywood. People who were just opposing unconstitutional, incoherent edicts in order to reopen their businesses and feed their families. To be clear, none of the things they said about these protests were accurate. Nobody spit on cops, nobody was burning flags. One lady had a wrongly drawn swastika that was done in satire, not to promote Nazism. One guy may have had a Confederate flag, but the point is, these people were broadly generalized and demonized for political purposes. Fast forward to the current situation, which our media has consistently described as peaceful, despite the obvious mass violence, rioting, and looting across the nation. How strange is it that the same people that were attacking the anti-lockdown protests for 11 allegedly spreading the virus and killing old people now suddenly rationalize excuses for why it's different when they do it. The same medical workers that were appalled by the anti-lockdown protesters were now endorsing these much larger, tightly packed mass protests as good for public health. What? Even the Grim Reaper guy who publicly shamed beachgoers now suddenly thinks it's fine to be in a much larger, densely packed city. What? So while all this obvious hypocrisy and contradictions were going on, folks like us were constantly pointing out that if there was another outbreak, it would have been started by these protesters. It didn't matter though, because the media has kept those wagons circled and came up with excuses to, as always, give the left a special pass. And now, 2 weeks later, cases in these cities are predictably spiking. A rational, sane human being would think to themselves, well, yeah, that makes sense. You just had thousands of protests across this country for 2 weeks in tightly packed cities for nearly 24/7. Is that what the media did?
No. As restrictions ease, nearly half of the state's 27,000 cases affecting people between the ages of 20 to 44 years old.
Before the reopening, they predicted 600 total deaths in Arizona.
What's actually happening is that all these damn capitalists and their businesses are reopening. He mentions Arizona, but doesn't mention that Arizona just had 12 straight days of protests. Because you see, reopening is something that Trump, Republicans, and conservatives wanted to do, not the left or Democrats. The modern media only exists as a propaganda vehicle for those two groups. They can't, won't put any blame for this spike on their foot soldiers. No, they'll do what they always do and put the blame squarely on their political opposition. That's all for today, folks. Please hit that like button, share, and subscribe. It really helps this channel. If you want to support this channel, you can do so on one of these platforms. You can find all those links in the description and pinned comment. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.